So the liver will start anyway. Let's go. Is that Hashem? We're starting. Daf Yud Bet. Daf Yud Gimel. The Gemara says. So we said that on the Ta'anit that they make for the Geshamim, Revi'it Hayom, they do a half a day Me'ayinin and Bemili Dimata, and Revi'it Hayom B'Sifrav, Karina B'Sifrav Aftarta, and Revi'it Hayom, they pray Modim Mitvadim Shtachavim LaHashem Elohim. And we said Mitzafra Kinufya, in the morning they gather, and in the afternoon they are praying to Hashem. And praying and reading the Torah. Says Gemara, Epuchana. Let's switch it. Maybe they should pray and learn half a day in the morning, and do the Ma'inina b'mili demata in the afternoon. Lo salga daitach, it can't be. Dichti ve'elai asifu kol hared b'dvere Elohei Yisrael al ma'ala gola. Everybody get it. Miyuchtiv u'b'minhat ha'erev kamti mita'aniti ve'efresa kapay el Hashem. So he says, in mincha, I got up and I prayed. Rashi. Epuchana de palga de omakama havukaru maftere ubao rahame ubeidach palga me'ayne. And if you're going to say that, then it's going to come out that it's not mitzafra kinufya, it's a beramsa kinufya. In the afternoon is the kinufya. And then maybe the isur melacha will only be from the afternoon. So we say al ma'ala gola. They gather al ma'ala gola. So it says vani yoshev mishomem. עד מנחת הערב, ובמנחת הערב קמתי מתעניתי, ובקוראי בגדי ומעילי, ואחראה על ברכי ואפרסה כפי אל השם אלוהי. So you see, ובמנחת הערב קמתי, אלמה באידך פלגה באו רחמה, עד פניה. The rest of the day they pray until the afternoon. מכלל, the פלגה קמה מעיני במילי דמטה. Must be in the morning is when they were investigating the deeds of the city. Amar Afram Bar Papa Amar Afizda. Kol Shum Mishum Evil. Anything that's considered any time where the Isur Rechitza is because of Avelut, Kigon Tisha Be'av Ve'Avel. For example, Tisha Be'av and Avel. Right? Asur ben behamim ben mitzonen. So then the isur hitza applies to hot water and cold water. Kol shum mishum ta'anug. Whenever the isur, that's the wrong. Give him this one. Kol shehu. Abu Dazayir. Kol shehu mishum ta'anug. Anything which is ta'anug. Page Yud Gimel. Kol shehu mishum ta'anug. Anytime the washing is just because of enjoyment and there's no avelut component, kigon ta'ani tzibur, when they're fasting for the rain, there's no avelut on that. It's just that ta'aisu ta'anug. Behamin asur betzonen mutar. You're not allowed to wash with hot. With cold, it's mutar. Rashi. Actually, before we do this piece, let's just read the rest of the Rashi's. Nehemiah ben Chachliya ketiv ve'ezra. In Sefer Nehemiah, it says about Ezra ve'elai yasifu. Li ayu mitasfinu ba'im tovim shebahem. The good ones came lagid lefanai. They told me al mal v'heta gola, about what the isurim were lafrisham, so I could separate them. Oshev mishtomem. Mishomem is turdim belaz al ma'alam shemitvadim al minhat ha'er. They were saying vidui until the mincha mechatzot va'elach shatzel note, when the shade starts tilting. V'masechet yomatz lote davra mechi meshachre katle kamti mita'aniti. So Rashi says, lo shemita'ane ad mincha v'harkach uchem. He says, I got it from my fast. Doesn't mean I broke the fast. Ela klomar mitza'er nafshe. Ubikar'i. I was afflicting myself. I ripped my clothes. Ve'im sha'ani korea bigadi u'me'ili. Even though I was ripping my clothes, ayiti mitfalil. I was praying, kedeh she'etratzeh, so Hashem will favor me. So how's he explaining kamti mita'aniti?
This is
And I got up from sitting in the fast, and I started to pray. So the Gemara says, Amar Papa, Amar Afra Papa, Amar Rav Chisda, Koshu Mishum Avel, anytime the Isur is Avelut, Kigon Tisha Be'av, the Avel Asur Ben Bechamim Ben Betzonen, let's see Rashi. Kol Ta'anit, She'asru Hachamim Rechitza Mishum Evel, with his Avelut, Kigon Tisha Be'av, Shum Mishum Avelut Horban, there's Avelut on the Horban, the Kol Sheken Avel Mamash, certainly a regular Avel, Shemetole Fanav, the Itle Tzara Tuva, he has a lot of suffering. Asur is not allowed to wash Ben Behamim Ben Mitzonin. The Gemara continues, Kol Shum Mishum Tanug, anytime it's Asur because of enjoyment. Kigon Ta'anit Zibur, Behamin Asur, you're only not allowed to wash with hot water. Bitzonin Mutar, but you're allowed to wash with cold water. Rashi. Mishum Ta'anug, Shemitzarim Ve'osrim Atzman B'Ta'anug, we're withholding Ta'anug. So then it's only what's a tanug is asur, which is hot water. Mashenke and avilu, we have to show tsar. That's asur even in cold water. Amar of Idi Bar Avin, Hafana Namitaneina, he says, Al Mishnah supports this position that anything that's anytime it's only asur because of tanug, it's only asur in hot water. Because it says, Vinoalim et temer hatzaot, they lock the bathhouses. Bathhouses are where you get hot water. Shema mina, cold water is mutar. Right? Hachi Garcina, Rashi says, Amar of Idi Barvin, Afana, Nami Tanena, Vino Alimet Amir Hatzaot. The Amar Le Abaye, so Abaye says, Ibit Sonen Asur. So Abaye, sorry, okay, let's wait. Look in the Gemara. Amar Le Abaye, what's your diuk? If it was asur in cold water, what do you want us to say? That we block off the rivers? Cold water is available to everyone. Even if it's asur, we're not going to lock them. So where do you see that cold water is mutar? From the fact that we don't lock the rivers? Rashi.
It
says asur b'chitza. Golden hot. Look at Rashi. I'm going to buy a ibit on in a susu crinet and home if I let me have it. What do you want? Afanan tanene bemadnit in the katani gabet anit suvenot mechzaot. Taino hamin. I'm also in mutar. Marlo abaye. Kilomar. We have a svira lele tan if the tana would have helped. The bitsonen asur hechi have a bayle mitne. What would you want him to say? Sochrimet a nearot hechi matzil mischirin. How are you going to close him? Amar Rav Shisha bered Rav Idi. Rav Shisha bered Rav Idi says. Rav Shisha bered Rav Idi says. Abba hachi kamar. My father Rav Idi Baravin. He said like this. His question was. Mehdi. Tanan, it says, Asur Birchitza. It says already that it's Asur. It says it's Asur Birchitza. Right? No alimita merchatza olam ali. What does it have to say, no alimita merchatzaot? What's that doing for me? What's it adding to my Isur Hitza? Right? El alav shma mina. It must be. It's coming to teach you. Behamin asur, betzonen mutar. The reason when it says no alim etemer hatzaot, it's coming to define the isur hitza. So what it just said asur hitza? I know it's asur hitza. No alim etemer hatzaot. If nobody can wash, why not? Why? Well, of course they're going to be locked. You can open with no customers. So. What does it mean? No alim to mahatzaot. That's the definition of the isur hitza. Shema mina v'hamin asu betzonen mutar.
No, we need to say that it's isur with the hot water, not with the cold.
Right. The definition is by mahatzaot. Rashi. Abba. Rav Idi hachi kakashile b'matnitin. Deka amar shema mina dula asar elahamin. Mechdi. Katani matnitin, it says in the Mishnah, asurim berchitza. Testam rechitza, your average rechitza is ben behamin, ben sonin. Hot and cold. Lamali tulim edar omitni avinu alim. What do you have to write that you lock him? Ela lememra must be coming to teach me the daf kahamin. Only hot water is asur. Lema misayei alei. Let's say we could prove Rafram's position, right? Miss Kol Hayave Tevilot, all people that have to dip, go to the mikveh. Tovlim Kedarkam, they go to the mikveh regularly. Ben b'Tisha B'Av, ben b'Yom HaKippurim. On Tisha B'Av, and on Yom HaKippurim. This Braita goes according to, maybe it's a Mishnah, goes according to the opinion that holds Tevilah b'Zman HaMitzvah. And therefore, when I'm Mevatel the Mitzvah on Yom Kippur or Tisha B'Av. B'mai. What are they going in? Ilema b'hamin.
They're working a concert now.
If you're talking in hot water, tevila b'hamin mi'ika, is the tevila in hot water? She'ubin ninu. In order to eat the water, you have to put it in a pail, to put it in a pot and boil it. Putting it in a pot makes it she'ubim is posil the mikveh. Elalav, not everybody has that girsa. The Gaon says to take it out. Tevot elu mechukim. Elalav b'tzonen. Must be he's gone to the mikveh in cold water. In and only someone that needs the mikveh could go. But someone who doesn't is not allowed to use even cold water. So you see that an avel and Tisha B'Av is asur even in cold water. Rashi. Leime misayei alei. L'rav hizda damar kol shum mishum evel asur afilu b'tzonen. Kol hayave tevilo. For example, nidav yoledet who go at night, tovlim kedarkan. Tevila behamin mi'ika. Hame ha'ur. If you heat up the water with the fire, hashiuvininu. They were drawn. Elala betzonen. Must be dipping in cold water. The hayave tevilot in mishum de tefila bezman ha'mitzvah shememahel letaher atzmo. He's purifying himself. Hachi garsina kule alma lo. The rest of the people can't. That was only for the good. It's not the average hot water. The average hot water is like in a mirchatz. They heat it up and they pour it in. So we say, Amarav Hana Parkatina. No, that's not what it's talking about. The chidush is lo nitzrecha ela lehamit veria. I have a mikveh that's kosher, that's hot water, hamit veria. It's a natural hot spring. And that's what it's saying. The kol hayaveh tevilo tovlim kedarkam in hamit veria. Says the Gemara. Yeah, is that what it's talking about? Ihachi, if you're telling me it's talking in Hamet Veria, Ema Seifa, look at the Seifa. Amar Bi Hanina Skanakoni. He argues, he says, Kedayu Bet Elokenu, the Bet HaMikdash is Kedai, the Abed Alav, to lose for it. Tevila Pama Habashana. Miss one Tevila once a year for on Tisha B'Av. Don't go to the mikveh. If you tell me that it's only asur to go to mikveh in hot water, why lose it to Tevilah? Just go to the coast. Don't go in Hamet Veria, go in the Kinneret. Right? Everybody knows the Kinneret is right there, and it's a kosher mikveh. But why can't you go to the mikveh? Why do you have to be ma'abit? Tevilah ha, pa'ama ha'bashana. Right? Amar b'tzonen mutar. If you're going to argue on chista, I'm going to say tzonen and mutar. And when we were only osir in chamet veria, yirchat b'tzonen. Let him go in the cold water. Bishlam. If you say like Rav Chista, the cold water is also asur, right? I think that one. Right. Right? If you say that cold water is asur, so that's why he has to be ma'abed tevila pa'am ha'bashana. But if you say even cold water is mutar, only hot water is asur, what's your problem? Don't go in hametveria. Says Gemara, Amar Rav Papa, I'll answer you. Be'atra dolo shachiach tzonen. This is a place where the only spring is a hot spring. It's not hametveria. It's a different hamin. Right. Rashi. Lo nitzrecha ela lehamet veria velkach. Hayavet tevilot in, only hayavet tevilot you go. Kule amalo. If so, Rabbi Hanina, Sgana Konin, Kedai, Ra'ui hu bet elokenu, that you should miss one tevila, and therefore even hayavet tevilot asur. Vim ita, kedemukmat le betzonen shar, if you all cold water is mutar, ma'ika mehadele Rabbi Hanina le tanakama, mi'ibu tevila. What's he saying? You should even miss the tevilah. Nehi delav lo tavli behamin. Even though they can't go in hot water mishum kabod betulenu, because of the respect of the Beit Hamikdash's laws, hamatzu tavli betzonen. Let him go in the cold mikvah. Elalav betzonen ami asur. Asur also in cold water. V'ainu d'amar le'abed. That's why you have to lose the tevilah. Amar Rav Papa Rashi le'olam behamet tveria. V'ainu d'kamrina. What we said, chayve tevilah. Cold water, anybody could go. Umayli ibude kamar bihanina, kigon beatra, tolo shachiach tzonen. In a place where cold water is not available. Okay.
But ends up being only because of shulvin, right? Medveria is only because of oneg, not shulvin. He's not going to heat it up.
It's not. There's no problem with shulvin because it's heated. It comes out. Comes out hot. Yes. Tashim, I'll bring you another proof. Kishe amru when they said asur b'melacha, when they said yinaler du melacha lo amru ela b'yom. They only said in the day you can't do melacha, but at night on the Ta'anit Tzibur, like we said yesterday, is mutar. Ukshamru asur benilat asandal. When they said you're not allowed to wear shoes, lo amru ela ba'ir, only in the city. Aval baderech, where it's an extra sa'ar, mutar. Haketzet, so how does it work? Yotze laderech, when he goes on the way, no il, you put him on. Nechnas lay, when he comes into the city, holetz, you take him off. Amru asur when they said you're not allowed to wash, lo amru ela kol gufo. They only said you're not allowed to wash your whole body. Aval panav yadav veraglav mutar, but your hands, your face, and your feet is mutar. Rashi. Kishamru asur b'mlacha gabe ta'ane tzibur, lo amru ela bayom. It's only asur in there. Balayla mutar. Rashi throws it. Mehacha mashma. Over here it's mashma. De belele tisha be'av mutar b'mlacha. Hare tisha be'av is a ta'ane tzibur. Mashma should be mutar b'mlacha. Ve'en bitul bo ela b'yom. It's only asur in the day. Aval en mefarsemim adavar. Okay? That's what Rashi seems to be saying. Yotze laderech. Chutz la'ir. Now the Mishnah continues. The Braita continues. Ve'chen ata motze b'menudeh ve'avel. The same law applies to someone that's in Harim who also has a certain amount of Dine Abidu. And the same thing applies to an Avil. Right? So what are you going to say? Ubimai. We're asking the opposite question over here. Over here we're asking, if you're saying v'chena ata motze b'menudeh ve'avel legaber hitza, that only kol gufo is asur, but panav yadav v'raglav is mutar. So by avel, what does it mean panav yadav v'raglav is mutar? It can't be talking about hamin. It has to be talking about sonen. Let's see. Right? B'may askinan. Ilema b'hamin. If you're talking about hot water, so you'll say like this. Ta'anit tzibur, you're not allowed to wash your whole body in hot water. But you're allowed to wash panav yadav v'raglav in hot water. So you're going to say that an avel is allowed to wash his hands, his face and feet in hot water? My love, akulu, lechaura, v'chen atam motzim b'menudez, going on all of them. Ubimai askina, what? Ilayim b'hamin, if he's talking, he's washing in hot water, panav yadav v'raglav mi'isharu, Is an avail allowed to wash his hands, face, and feet in hot water? The Ha'amar Rav Sheshat, Rav Sheshat said, avail asu lo shit etzba'o behamin. Avail can't even stick his finger in hot water. El alav bitzonen. Must be talking, the avail is in cold water. And therefore we're saying, v'chein ata motzei b'menudeh avail, that they can't wash their whole body in cold water, but they can wash their hands, face, and feet in cold water. And the same thing is by ta'anit zibur. So you see ta'anit zibur, kol gufo in cold water is asur. Not like Rav Chista. This is Gemara lo. Le'olam, that whole bright is talking b'hamin. So that when it says, you can wash, you can't wash your whole body with hands, face, and feet, you can wash in hour. Utkakashi lecha, this is what I told you. Nechen ata motze b'menudeh b'avel. And so too you see, by menudeh and avel, that these leniencies apply. Hasha'ara is going on the rest of them. Going on ne'ilata sandal on the way. But the rinsing doesn't apply the same rules to avel because there's the avelut component. Rashi. וכן אתה מוצא במנודה באבל. הכי גסינה במאי. What do you say? אילה אם בחמין. מישאר יולד ראש מנודה באבל וחמין פניו ידה ורגליו. ואמר רב ששת אבל אסור להושיט עצמו בחמין. אלא לב בצונן. מה אליו הכולו? Meaning, הדקתני וכן אתה מוצא במנודה באבל. הכל הניקה, it's going on all of them. ואפילו הרחיצה, even on washing. ושמע מנה, we see from there, בתענית ציבור, אסור לרחוץ כל גופו ואפילו בצונן וטיוב דלרף רמבר פאפה לא השערה קי הנעילה ושיחה it's going on נעילת הסנדל and on שיחה אני בשיחה אז אני הפרייטה he says הנעילה ומלאכה the Bach says But melacha is also a problem. Because you don't say that an avel is allowed to do work at night. Tosor also says, I love a sikha. How does he say melacha? Okay. So the Gemara says, Ashara is only going on the other ones, not going on the chitza. Tashima, not a proof. The Amar Rabbi Abba, says, Rabbi Abba Kohen, Mishum Rabbi Yossi Kohen, Maase Ometu Manavshul Rabbi Yossi Ben Rabbi Hanina. Rabbi Yossi, the son of Rabbi Hanina's sons died. Berachat Betzonen Kol Shiv'a. He washed in cold water all 7 days. So the opposite. You see that an avel is mutar bitzonen. And you told me the avel is different, even bitzonen is asu. So he says, no. Hatam kishetachvu avilav. This is what we say, metu banav. They didn't die together. They died a week apart. So he had already said 7 days, and now he's going to have another shiva. It's two shivas in a row. It's too much for anybody. Rashi. ורחת בצונן כל שבעה גרסין אין אלמה בצונן שרי שתחפו אפלה בזה החזה כדקתני שמתו בניו שניהם ולפי כך התירו לו they will matir for him to wash בצונן all 7 days like we find another place that they will make kill on the hair by תחפו אפלה right? תניה תחפו אפלה זה אחר זה פי איזה דבל אפלות one after the other החביט שערו if his hair is too much make kill בתער He could lessen it with a ta'ar, with a shinui. Nobody normally cuts hair with a ta'ar. This guy, he could cut it off with a ta'ar. Avalo b'ta'ar. U'mechabes kisuto, and he could rinse his clothing b'mayim with water. Amar av chist. So that's the same thing. Just like they will mekel b'ta'ar and b'mayim, so too they will mekel to wash b'tzonen. Amar av chist, Rav Chista comments on that braita. This will be matir by tachfu avilav betar avalo b'misparayim. He can use a razor, not a scissor. B'mayim, he can use water, velo b'netev, velo b'chol, and he can't use detergent. Those were the detergents at the time. Rashi. Mekel betar de shikul shakil purta mina. They take a little off. Ubetar derech shinui neter karkahu o even ke en shikurin karia belaaz. Beneter behol derech lechabesh it laben. It gets wider. They not let it do. Amarava ravases. So Rav Chista held that an avel is not let to wash betzonein kol shivat. Amarava, no, I argue. Avel mutal lirchotz betzonein kol shivat. The avel is like the ta'anit zibur, and he's allowed to wash his whole body in cold water all 7 days. I'll prove it to you. Midi dehave abisra v'hamra, like meat and wine, right? Just like he's allowed to eat meat and he's allowed to drink wine, so too he's allowed to wash with cold water. Rashi, midi dehave abisra v'hamra de ta'anu gen ketzonen. Most of us think that meat and wine is a lot more pleasurable than washing in cold water. Unless it's in the summer, maybe. Meiti bay. I'll ask you a question. And a bogeret, Rashal, and Avelet Atzma. A bogeret. So in those days, bogeret was 12 and a half. Shevia shtei se'arot. So now she's ready to get married. And a bogeret, Rashal, and Avelet Atzma, bime evel aviha. She's not allowed to make herself look ugly. Not fix herself, even when she's sitting shiva for her father. Rashi. Ena na'ara shivya shtei se'arot. Rasha'a lenavel et atzma ela mikashetet. She puts on makeup. She has to look good. Kedei she'ikpitzu aleha, so they'll marry her. Ha na'ara she'ena re'uya li naseh. But when she's young and she's not ready to get married, adayin. She's allowed. She's already 12. She's chayav in avilut. The ketana ain't chayavet velo klum. The ketana is not chayav in avilut anyway, right? Ha na'ara, but a na'ara rasha'a. My love, what's the nivul that we're talking about? My love berhitza. Are we not talking about washing? Ubemai, and what type of washing? Ilema behamin, if you're in hot water. Ena bogeret rasha'a. You tell me a bogeret is not allowed to be mahmir, doesn't have to be mahmir and not wash with hot water. The Amar of Hizda Avel asul oshit etzba o behamin. The Avel is not allowed to stick his finger into hot water. So why should she be allowed to wash with hot water? It's not such a good question. Maybe that's talking about other people. Meaning why? Doesn't make sense. Hot water for sure you're not allowed. Because why do we have to be matil? Let her use cold water. Elalav bitzonen. Must be cold water. So the cold water, the na'ara has to be mahmir, and the bogeret doesn't. So you see that cold water is asur by an avel, and not like rava. Says Gemara Lo, who says Akichulu Pirchus is talking about putting on makeup. Now, which one of the Isurim of Avel is putting on makeup? So they say that it's part of Rechitza. It's included in the Gezerah of Rechitza. It's like a Kavah Homer. You have it a few places that it's mashma that it's asur. It says beferush that it's asur, right? But the bogeret is allowed. Lo akichulu pirchus. Rashi velo lo kamayri berchitza klal. Pirchus besear kibuz bebegadea rechitza baguf. So she's doing some kichul on the face and pirchus in the hair. Lema mesayei alei. The Amar Rabbi Abba Kohen. Mishum Rabbi Yossi HaKohen Maaseh Umetu Banav Shor Rabbi Yossi Bar Hanina Verhatz Betzonen Kol Shiva. So that's a proof to Rava that Rechitza Betzonen is Mutar. Amri, they answer, no. Hatam Mishetachvu Avelav Zeh Achar Zeh. Over there it's talking where he had a double Avelut. So in the second week they will make Betzonen, but you can't bring a proof that a regular Avel is Mutar. The Tanya, like we learned by other halachot, when the hair is too heavy, he can lessen it with a razor. And he washes his clothing with water. Amar of Hizdam, we said, "Betar v'lo b'misparayim, b'mayim." He can use water v'lo b'netev v'lo b'chol, v'not detergent v'lo b'ahal. That's the first lashon of Rava. Ika de Amri, others say, Amar Rava, Rava says, Havel asur betzonen kol shiva. The Havel is not allowed to wash even with cold water the whole 7 days, like Rav Chisna. Maishna mi basar v'yayin. Why should it be different than meat and wine? That's also enjoyable and the Havel is allowed. Hatam lifchu chefach dehu David. We let him drink wine to calm his nerves. We let him eat meat so he could feel healthy. But stam rechitza is ta'anug, we don't allow.
Avela's allowed to drink wine?
What?
Avela's allowed to drink wine?
Yeah, onen is not allowed basar v'yayin, but once he's avel, he's allowed.
Ah.
Let's say it's a proof. And a bogeret rasha'al in avelet atzma, the bogeret doesn't keep the avelut to make herself look ugly because she has to get married. A younger girl that's not looking to get married is allowed, has to keep avelut. Bemai, what are we talking about? Ilema behamin, hot water. The bogeret's allowed hot water. And a bogeret rasha'al, beha marav hezda, vela sulo shit, it's bo behamin. Can't use hot water. Elalav must be bitzonen. So you see, the Nahara can't wash in cold water either. And it's a proof to Rava that says that a Avel can't use cold water. Right? It's going on makeup.
Why would you repeat ourselves?
Why? Well, the Bogeret, the single girl, could put on makeup when she's Avel.
We just said this 5 lines ago.
This is the second Lashon, so they had to repeat the whole Shakla V'Tarya. Amar Rav Chisda, Zot Omeret Avel Asur B'Tachboset Kol Shiv'a. This teaches us that Avel is not allowed to wash his clothes all 7 days. Why? If we say that she's allowed to put on makeup and the other ones are not, who adin letachboset? So too, lechaorah, the other people are not allowed to wash their clothes. It seems like the bogeret is allowed. From Rashi, anyway. Velcheta, the halacha is Avel asul lerhot kol gufo. The Avel is not allowed to wash. Velcheta, Avel asul lerhot kol gufo. The Avel can't wash his whole body. Ben behamin, ben betzonen, not with hot, not with cold. Kol shiva, all 7 days. Aval panav yadav raglav, put his hands, his face, and his feet. Behamin asur, he's not allowed to wash with hot water. Betzonen mutar, he's allowed to use cold water. Aval lasuch, if he wants to put on creams or whatever. Afilu kol shu asur, even on part of his body is asur. Vim la averet azuama, but if he wants to get off the smell, mutar, it's mutar. Now, the Ran gives like a little summary. The reef is very short. Hilchita, you don't have a big deal. But the Ran says, so you have three categories. Betisha be'av is one. Ve'avel is two. Ta'anit zibur is three. The betisha be'av asuloshit afilu etz baketana b'mayim afilu betzonen. You can't stick your finger even in cold water, like it says in Pesachim. Ve'avel behamin asul legamr kol gufo. Ubitzonen mutal lirchot panav yadav v'raglav. He came avel as asur behamin altogether. Tzonen kol gufo, but panav yadav v'raglav betzonen is mutar. Ubetanit zibur mutal lirchot afilu kol gufo betzonen. Ubehamin in hot water kol gufo asur. Aval panav yadav v'raglav lo. והברייתא דתניא לאל כשאמרו אסור רחיצה לא אמרו אלא כל גופו ובניו ידיו ורגליו מותר is talking בחמין.
Okay.
Gemara says, "Shluta de ta'anita hechi matkirinan." Where do you say the prayer of ta'anit, which is anenu? Look in Rashi. תפילת הענית עננו. חד ברי רב יהודה לרב יצחק ברי, רב יהודה תוקסן רב יצחק, ודריש ענית וזדורש like this. יחיד שקיבל עליו תענית, היחיד הוא accepted a private fast, מתפלל של תענית. He does say עננו. והיכן אומרה, where should he say it? בין גואל לרופא. בין גואל לרופא, like the Hazan does. רשי, בין גואל לרופא ברכה בפני עצמה. מה תקיף לה רב יצחק? וכי יחיד, קובע ברכה לעצמו, is the יחיד, תענית, strong enough to be able to make his own ברכה? רשי, וכי יחיד חשוב כל כך, שיהיו מתקנים לו ברכה בפני עצמה להוסיף בתפילתו? אלא אמר רבי יצחק ושומע תפילה. רבי יצחק says stick the ענינו in without its own ברכה and שומע תפילה. רשי ושומע תפילה שכוללה בתוך הברכה. יקלור אין הברכה וחותם ושומע תפילה דעותה ברכה וחתימתה משמע בין התענית בין הקומילי. ברוך אתה השם שומע תפילה כבי שומע תפילה ותענית שומע תפילה רגילה. וכן אמר רב ששת בשומע תפילה. רב ששת also said you say it in שומע תפילה. מייטי ביי, אין בין יחיד לציבור, it is not even יחיד לציבור, אלא שזה מתפלל 18, וזה מתפלל 19. This guy prays 18, and this guy prays 19. מה יחיד ומה ציבור? ואז מין יחיד ואז מין ציבור. אילאי מיחיד ממש וציבור, שליח ציבור. If the יחיד refers to an individual, a regular guy in the cow, and the tzibur means the hazan, ani 19, only 19 berachot, 24 havu. The hazan on the ta'anit, he prays 24 berachot, like the Gemara is going to say in the second perek. Rashi, 19, en ben yachid lezibur gabe ta'anit, sheze yachid mitpalel biyom ta'anit to 18, vekolel tfilah ta'anit b'shomea tfilah. And the tzibur says, Tishaisre, the kavale ben goel erofe. Stam tefila kari shmonaisre, why? The berkavala melshinim, the yavne tekmua, like it says in your berachot. Even though we have 19, originally it was 18. But the tzibur chavdal ravyan, בפרקין דל קמד, דקת ברכות אבו ביומד את העניתה. ואחר קטני יוטט ותולו. So how could ציבור refer to the חזן? So we're going to have to re-engineer this ברייטה. אל עליו, הכי כאמר. You have to say it like this. אין בן יחיד דקיבל עליו תענית יחיד. ליחיד שקיבל עליו תענית ציבור. It depends what type of תענית you're talking about. היחיד that accepted תענית יחיד, like he said, we said yesterday, הריני מחר לפניך בתענית יחיד, and he's going to eat in the night time, and he's not going to be אסור מחיצה, נעילת הסנדל, then he says 18 ברכות, right? But if he accepted, right? He accepted a תענית ציבור, and he's fasting from the night before, and he's not wearing shoes and the like, then he says a bingo, a little fib. So read it like this. אין בן יחיד לקיבל עליו תענית יחיד. ליחיד שקיבל עליו תענית ציבור, אלא שזה מתפלל 18. וזה מתפלל 19. But now, if a יחיד that accepted a תענית ציבור to pray 19, שמע מינה יחיד קובע ברכה לעצמו. In the end, a יחיד was חשוב enough fasting alone to make his own ברכה. So sometimes he'll say his own ברכה. רשי, וציבור יחיד שקיבל עליו תענית ציבור, עלמא יחיד קובע ברכה לעצמו כדי קיבל תענית ציבור. זה גמרא, לא, נרפוף. לעולם אין לך שליח ציבור. When we said ציבור makes 19, it's the חזן, not the יחיד. Because the יחיד will never say more than 18. ותקקש לך ירד דפקולטי שליח ציבור 24 מצלה, the חזן has to say 24, not true. בשלוש תעניות ראשונות, דלק 24. So talking on the first 20, the first three fasts, that's a תענית יחיד, תענית ציבור, but it's the lighter version, you eat at night. So therefore, those fasts, you don't do the 24 ברכות. ולא, is it true? והא אם בן קטני, in the next פרק it says, אם בן, maybe it's this פרק. It's in the Mishnah over here.
You said it before, no?
Is here now, Mishnah? No.
What's the problem?
We said it yesterday.
No. There's an Embin. Maybe it's a brighter. Baha. M ben Katani. M ben Shalosh Rishonot. The Shalosh im Tzayo. There's no difference between the first three and the middle three. Ela Shebe'elu Mutarim Ba'asya Melacha. Ube'elu Asurim Ba'asya Melacha. On the first three, you're allowed to do melacha. On the second three, you're not allowed to do work. Halak Avdalid, to pray 24 berachot, ze ve ze shavit. Says Gemara, that is Bashir. We said some differences and we left out some differences. Says Gemara, my shir, the high shir. Show me something else. If you show me something else, I believe you that you left this out. The two. And another question, they take it out. Some have the Gisav too by Emben Katani, because by an Emben you don't generally say Tana Mishiyah. But even if you want to say, but if you want to say, Kanere, the Emben is Lav Davka. Ela, you have to answer like this. Tana bi Isure Kamari, bi Tefilolo Kamari. When the Tana said there's no difference, he wasn't talking about the whole Seder Tani. He was talking about which Isuri, what things are Asura on the Tani. But he wasn't talking about. Pray. Says Gemara. Forget about all this. If you want, I'll tell you. Maybe on the three middle ones, you also don't say 24 berachot. Only in the last seven. Don't we have a bride? On these, you blow shofar and you lock up the stores. Halikol devrehem. For everything else, zeveze shavim, they're the same. Vechi tamer, what are you going to say? Hachanami tana v'shiyer. Also between the middle three and the last seven, you'll say that they left something out of the tefillah. Ha emben katani. It says emben v'tizbera. Emben dafka. Could the emben be dafka? Ha shiyer teba. They left out the fact that on the middle three, you don't take the teba, you don't take the hechal out to the street to pray in the street. And on the last seven, you take the hechal out. So you see, when it said emben, it didn't mean there's no differences. It meant pretty much the same. Imishum teba lav shiurahu. The teba is not a shiur. Hani mili ditzina katan. Mili ditzina katan. We only said the private things that you don't see. Mili de pavaresia, the stuff that you do in the street, lo katani, we didn't mention. Rashi. Tana v'shiyer. Sorry. The elu mutarim ba'asiyah malacha rishonot, the first three, the lo hamiri kulay, that are not so severe. Halakav dala berachot, for the 24 berachot, zeviz shavim. The kasal gadaitach, we thought, the itinu lekav dala be'emtzayot, that the 24 berachot apply on the middle fast. Mid the kamitarit kamaita, the leka kavdalid. When we said that the first three, it's talking, when it says, the Chazan says 19, that we said it's talking on the first three fasts. Why don't we say the middle three? Because the middle three has 24. Only the first three doesn't.
I'm saying I'm waiting for them? Hmm? Well, I should start.
Michlal dem ben zayot itinu. You're probably assuming that you have it. Velohi says Rashi. Lema'ase, it's not true. Delitinu ele ba'acharonot. In the end, we're going to say it's only in the last seven. Kedekatani hata, like it says there. Umishum daha milta kamaita. Mishum hachi parich lemikavdale delitinu ben zayot. He goes, this is the first part we're asking from the middle, from the 24 that doesn't apply to the middle one. I don't know exactly what Rashi means.
You have to hear it, because how can I be motzi someone if he doesn't hear it? There's no way him to be motzi if he doesn't hear it.
Let's say it's great, but it's a lot better than the other things. It said things between them. Vishier, and they left out. It says Emben lav davka. We'll see that Emben is not always davka. So it also proves it. Show me something else. Ella, you have to give me a different answer. When it says Emben, it's talking about the Isurim of the Fetz, but we don't look Amadi. The one that throws in here, Motzime Teva is a mistake. The Ena Eleba Haronot, you wouldn't ask that, because it only applies on the last seven. Kedib Samuch, like we're going to say later. And the Tan already knew that, the Ena Eleba Haronot. Why, when it comes to the 24, they thought that applies even in the middle three? So they said, no, you see, if it's in the middle three, it's in the first three. But the Teva, they knew already from the beginning, it's only in the last seven. So we say no. Between the last three and the last seven, the middle three and the last seven, the difference is 24 berachot. Show me something else. The lav urcha de tana lemini kol mili. It's not the derech to say everything, ulishur hada, and to leave one thing out. If he left two things out, you can tell me he left a few things out. But if he left nothing out, can't be. Ela, you have to say le'olam kaf dalet bekamaita litinu. Really, the 24, not on the first ones. Ulahachi lo hashiv le be'emben de betfila lo kamari. I'm not talking about tefila. Or we'll say be'emtzayo nami leka kaf dalet el ba'charonot kedamrinan hatam. We have a braita that says she'be'elu ha'charonot matri'im v'no'alim. No. Tana v'shiyer. Was lav davka. I left out teva. The baharonot ita. Hachalekta. Kedekatani lekaman. Say the taniot keitzad. Motzim et teva. Umotvina begmara beedya miteva. Delet el baharonot. Umishani ki katani nami matnitin. Baharonot. No, teva is not a shiur. Mili ditzina, matriim bebet hakeneset. They blow the shofar in the shul. They kavdale nami bebet hakeneset. They prayed in the bet hakeneset. So when they take the teva, after they pray? That's a cholod, they pray in bet hakeneset. That's what it sounded like. Okay, Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen ve'amen. Stop, Richard.